in Valdosta City, Council District 3, Sunny Diggers in attendance, or any other candidates from District 3. Next, we'll move on to Valdosta City District 5, Tim Carroll. Is there anyone else in the audience from District 5?
Thanks, Laverne. Quick show of hands, how many people in here speed read? Just a quick show of hands. Good, because I did that a few weeks ago when I got an email from Tom Huscho. It asked me if I wanted to come speak at the last county Democratic Party. I didn't read into it that it was going to be my campaign speech. But no fear. I can do this off the top of my head. Yeah, I can do this. But I do want to take a quick moment and thank Tom, Democratic Party staff, and everybody who puts these events together. Before I got elected to office years ago, I typically did not come to these type of events. Now, I was an engaged voter, don't get me wrong, but I typically did not get involved on a local level. And over the years, having attended numerous campaign events, both Democratic and Republican, the one consistent thing I've always seen out of the LCDP is they are engaged, they are energized, and they work hard. And I applaud you. But also got to give a shout out, you know, like many of you, how many people in here work for a living? having attended maybe a training session in Dublin at the DuBose Porter Technical College campus out there, great facility, you've done a great, great service to the state of Georgia in many things, but you've also served Dublin and Orange County so extremely well. Our company I work for is based out of Dublin, Georgia, and largest employee-owned company in the state that's registered in the state. Thank you very much. But Dublin and Orange County has been really getting it out of the park with economic development over the last 5 to 7 years. And that's a community that we need to keep looking at because they have been doing it right, they have been securing jobs, and more importantly, they've been securing good jobs. My hat's off to them. But we can't do this stuff alone. It takes cooperation. Now you may say, Tim, what are you going to bring to cooperation? That's one component that I've tried to put into place over the last 8 years, serving as your representative from District 5 in the City Council. And that's understanding that in everything we do, we don't do it in a vacuum. We do it through cooperation. We do it with compromise, and we do it with listening, and we do it with understanding. And that is one strength that I've tried to engage. I can't tell you I've worked every single time, but I've tried to bring to the table in the City Council, tried to bring to the table in negotiations and conversations with the county commissioners, with our state representatives, with our federal representatives, is everything we do, we have to do together for the better of the whole. And that's something that each one of us on mayor and council, each one of us on county commission, each one of us on state delegation, federal delegation, that we must continue to work hard at to do, in that we don't just represent Republicans. We don't just represent Democrats. We represent people. And if we're going to be that voice, if we're going to be able to represent and be a voice for all the people throughout not only my district, this city, but our community as a whole, and hopefully our state and country. We have to be willing to listen, we have to be willing to engage, and we have to be willing to occasionally challenge ourselves to do better. And that's another thing that I've always worked at trying to do. I'm trying to be engaged, try to work hard, be prepared, but in doing so, recognizing that I've got a cross-section of people that I represent. One of the biggest topics everybody's been talking about has been public transportation. Now let's go. We had a presentation tonight, And I want to take this moment, not so much to promote it for a campaign theme, but to promote it and that we're asking for civic engagement. And since the Democratic Party of Lamb's County engages and gets involved, I want to encourage every one of you to plug in and participate in the citizen survey. The topic says $1 billion for transportation. That's a big number. That's 25 years worth of transportation projects that are currently being studied and prepared for utilizing federal dollars, most of them, not all. And included in that is public transportation. When you talk about this kind of money that's going to be invested in our transportation, it's going to help not only move vehicles around our city, not only help move people around our city, but also aid in education and economic development, amongst other things. We need all the input we can get. You know, I, as an elected official, it is so much easier to vote when you know and feel good about what you've been hearing from your constituents. What have you been hearing? And if the majority of my constituents are coming up to me and saying, look, Tim, you're absolutely nuts. JD doesn't know math. We can't afford this. Then am I going to vote for it? No. But if I've got folks who can do math, I thought that was just and I've got constituents talking about the need for this and the economic development benefits of it, the educational benefits of it, then obviously it opens that door and encourages elected officials to make decisions that are not always going to be popular across the board. Now, I know, stay elected, I know you guys have felt it because you're up there in the heat of politics. You know, I don't know what kind of politics we call that between the Republicans and Democrats at the state level. Texas heard me say this before, but now DuBose, and I think you might appreciate this, that right now, I think that between January the 15th and March the 15th is the most dangerous time in the state of Georgia. There have been a number of Republicans that somehow or another don't think cities are worth all that they're up to. And this transportation bill is one of them. So as a result of that transportation bill, we're going to see an 18.2% increase in our fuel just to run city vehicles because of the excise tax. I did this off the top of my head. I hope I didn't do too bad. But I'm not going to keep you much longer. If your butt is sore as mine is sitting in the chairs this month, I'm sure you're ready to get up and move. So before I step off the stage, I want everybody to stand up. Come on now.